This is an introduction to the grounding meditation. If this is the first time you have played the recording, these remarks will help explain the meditation before you do it. The information given will help you understand the meditation more fully and experience more benefit from it. This grounding meditation is designed to help you be as grounded as you can be at any particular time. To be grounded is simple. It is to be physically aware of your bodily sensations and, at the same time, to be physically aware of what is happening around you. Being grounded is to do with physical awareness of the inside and the outside worlds. The physical aspect of your awareness is fundamental. What are the benefits of doing this? The benefits are both general and specific. The general benefits of being well grounded all of the time are very widespread. They are in every area of people's lives. This seems largely to be due to the way people's naturalness is released when they are grounded. Briefly put, experience seems to indicate two things. First, when we are well grounded, ease, harmony, light, sweetness and fragrance automatically intensify and expand throughout our systems. At the same time, our discomforts, disharmonies, dullness and unpleasantness automatically dissolve and disappear. You can experiment for yourself. Whenever you are feeling happy, loving, secure or fulfilled, get yourself fully grounded and notice how your experience spreads, maintains and frequently intensifies. Then, if you feel sad, scared, angry, anxious or discomforted in some way, get yourself grounded and notice how the discomfort dissolves and disappears. This happens very quickly at times, and sometimes more slowly. The second general benefit is related to the first. Many qualities and experiences are natural to human beings. Some of these may be a pleasant surprise to you. Natural experience includes love, liveliness, vitality, joy, peace, strength, compassion, tenderness, relaxation, flexibility, ease, humor, beauty, clarity, harmony, quiet, fragrance, and security. Over and over again, when people have practiced being well grounded all of the time, the experiences just listed have come to form a greater and more central part of their daily experience. Sustained groundedness clears out the collected discomforts and difficulties and releases us to enduring well-being as our inherent nature expresses itself more and more strongly in our lives. The third general benefit is to do with another natural aspect of human beings. This is that human beings have a highly developed capacity to establish and re-establish inner balance, ease, fullness and security. There are natural processes in us which take care of imbalances, discomforts and problems. Being well grounded is the key to ensuring that these natural processes take care of things. These natural processes operate amazingly quickly, deeply and fully, and at the same time they are automatic. They occur without thought or concentration. Being well grounded is the key. Being well grounded stimulates and enhances these natural processes so that they will operate fully. If you have recurring and troublesome thoughts or feelings, for example, you can use grounding to help you. If they start to occur, get well grounded and notice how quickly you return to equilibrium. Perhaps there is some past incident about which you have recurring memories. Well, grounding can help you. Each time you remember, all you do is ground yourself fully. You can find that quite rapidly you only remember the incident without feeling, or even that you can no longer remember it at all. The time taken for this result varies, so for some it can occur in seconds, while for others it may take weeks or months. It depends both on the particular person and the issues with which he or she is dealing. So there are these general benefits. The specific benefits are similar to these. You can intensify your groundedness in a matter of seconds. So you can do the grounding whenever you want to do it, whatever you are doing at the time. When you wish to intensify specific pleasures, therefore, you can do so by grounding yourself in the midst of the experience. By grounding yourself, for example, as you enjoy a joke, look at a sunset, express love to someone, eat a delightful meal, or listen to beautiful music, you can find your delights increasing. So you can use grounding to expand the enjoyment and excitement in your life. You can also use it in any challenging situations when experiencing some difficulty. Being well grounded will help you stay or become calm, relaxed, secure, quiet, or transparent. Grounding helps greatly at such times by helping us stay in balance. It helps us manage our feelings, thoughts, and impulses while staying aware of what is happening. The interview with the boss, the speech to a group of strangers, the exam or test, the feared situation, the anxiety or panic attack, etc., can all become manageable, even enjoyable, with grounding. Many people have found that grounding has rendered the trials and tribulations of such events a thing of the past. This means, to say it again, that you can use grounding to strengthen and balance you as you cope with the difficulties and challenges of your life. Now, how does all this work? At least some part of the answer to this question is seen in a sometimes neglected reality. Human beings are animals. We have been evolving for millions of years. In that time, we have become amazingly sophisticated organisms. A part of that sophistication is that we have all sorts of natural, automatic, physical processes for maintaining our inner balance, harmony, light, and fragrance. For example, our hearts know when to beat faster, our lungs know when to make our breathing shallow or deep, our glands know when to secrete hormones and when to stop. And there is more. Our emotional and intellectual lives are based on bodily processes and patterns. This has a very interesting effect. When we allow the human animal each of us is to act naturally as a physical organism, then our mental and emotional balance or equilibrium is maintained with amazing ease. If ever these are lost, the restoration of physical balance and equilibrium is what restores emotional and intellectual balance and equilibrium. It seems that it is not natural to be out of balance in any way. When allowed to do what it has been evolving for millions of years to do, the human animal restores its equilibrium very rapidly indeed, its physical, emotional, and intellectual equilibrium. The obvious conclusion many people reach is that when disequilibrium occurs for any length of time, then something is interfering with the natural animal processes that would take care of things if they were allowed to operate. The key to getting the natural animal processes to operate is for us to stay well grounded. When well grounded, we allow the natural animal in us to take care of us fully. The full benefit of the millions of years of our evolution can then express itself in us and show itself to us. The animal we are is naturally and easily grounded. Ongoing awareness of our bodily processes and of the physical world around us is instantaneous and automatic. It is natural for us to be aware of our bodies and of the world around us all the time. It is routine, automatic, an ever-present part of animal experience. Animals are one with their sensations. When we were babies, we were one with our sensations too. As a result, babies tend to live pleasure-centered lives. When crises occur, babies respond with distress. When the crises are over, babies move on too and quickly become absorbed in pleasurable pursuits once more. By contrast, the older we became, the more we developed the capacity to separate from or reduce our awareness of the physical aspects of life, at least to some extent. Most adults can diminish awareness of their bodily sensations, of the world around them, or both. This capacity to reduce or remove physical awareness of the inside, the outside, or both has had benefits. But it is also an unfortunate development for our ongoing equilibrium. Diminishing awareness of the physical aspects of life actively creates disequilibrium by interfering with the natural effects of groundedness that I have already mentioned. When we ignore or minimize our awareness of our physical sensations and what we see, hear, feel, taste, or smell around us, we get less pleasure than we could, we are less capable of dealing with difficulties than we could be, and we return to balance and inner freedom during and after a crisis much more slowly, if at all. It is our capacity to interfere in our awareness of our bodies and the physical world around us that leads us into these unnecessary difficulties. Re-establishing our natural capacity for groundedness can correct all of this very quickly. I now turn to discuss more directly the meditation on this recording. The meditation helps you to stay grounded and to intensify how grounded you are. And there are four general points I make about it. First, when you do the meditation, you can realize very quickly that you are already grounded. You are not learning to do something new. The meditation helps you to do something more fully that you are already doing. Second, while the meditation here is for about half an hour, you can choose for how long you do it when you do it yourself. You can do the meditation for only a few seconds at a time, or you can do it for much longer periods. Every time you do it, you will be making yourself more grounded and so promoting the natural processes and results already mentioned. Third, the more you deliberately intensify or accentuate your grounding, the easier it is to stay grounded, because grounding is a natural process. It takes far more to interrupt it than to let it occur. So the moment you start to encourage groundedness, all the natural drive of your system rushes to your aid to complete and fulfill what is natural. The result is that every time you get yourself more grounded deliberately, you will usually stay more grounded for longer and longer. Eventually, you can be thoroughly grounded virtually all the time. Fourth, you can do the meditation in any situation while engaged in any activity, and it is completely private and instantaneous. I have already given a brief list of the contributions grounding can make to you. You may still wonder, however, with what types of things can the meditation help? The experience of many others supports you being very optimistic. The more you practice being grounded, the easier your life is likely to become. It seems that any area of life can be changed in some way through being well grounded. You can also use it specifically. It really helps release troublesome thoughts or feelings. It helps resolve past experiences which are unfinished. It helps you to remain calm and at ease, although extremely busy. It helps you to cope with yourself while you cope with difficult people. And it helps you to free yourself from stress and discomfort. In general, from now on you can remind yourself that being grounded is natural, that each time you deliberately notice your physical experience, you are more grounded, and that being more grounded is of great benefit under all circumstances. Being grounded brings each of us into the I am here and now. We become pinpointed so that all our strength, awareness and vitality are available. When you use the meditation, you are encouraging the natural release of your naturalness. This is something beautiful. There may be times when you quickly experience this beauty. There may be other times when you notice that to be grounded seems to intensify discomfort for a while. If discomfort persists, the best thing to do is to persist with being grounded. As you persist, do practical things to relieve your discomfort. By actively doing what you can to relieve yourself while you stay grounded, you will help your system to release itself more easily, more fully, and more quickly. Some of the instructions given during the meditation are specifically designed to help you do this. Just to summarize then, the purpose of being grounded is for you to be free, and sometimes freedom will come easily, and at other times it may take longer. What others have experienced is very clear. However long your equilibrium seems to be in coming, persistence with being grounded promotes its arrival. Now, in addition to playing the meditation regularly, you can do something else that may change your life dramatically. You can concentrate on grounding for 5 to 10 seconds every 15, 20 or 30 minutes from now on. Decide on the interval for yourself, then remind yourself in some way. Pay attention to the physical aspects of your inner and outer experience for 5 to 10 seconds at those times, and within 6 months your life can be transformed. Many who have done this have said, "I did not know life could be so easy. The difference regular grounding has made to me is almost unbelievable." You could try it too. All that you do is follow three basic steps. The first step is to notice the physical sensations in your body and the physical things and events around you at the same time. You do this by looking, listening, feeling, tasting and smelling what is happening physically inside your body. You also look at, listen to, touch, taste and smell the things and events around you. While doing this, you may shift your attention back and forth from inside to outside generally, or notice specific aspects of the inside or outside. The second step is to get up and move around from place to place, or to move the different parts of your body in relation to each other. All the while you continue with the first step. You may make your movements overt or subtle, depending on the situation in which you are doing the meditation. The third step is to guide your attention to what is easy, light, harmonious, fragrant and sweet on the inside and outside. You practice acting in a casual, easy, relaxed and alert manner throughout this, and you continue with steps 1 and 2. You keep recycling these steps at your own pace until you are released, free and alive. The more practiced you become, the easier these steps also become, and I think you will find the more you will do all the steps together as one act. I have now completed the introduction and wish you well with the results of the meditation.